We are given a proper data set with date, sales rep, and sales. But because we want to be able to add records to the bottom of the table later and have our reports and charts update, we want to first convert the proper data set into an Excel table. The way you do this is you make sure that you have a proper data set, field names in the first row, records in subsequent rows, and then you click in a single cell. Don't highlight sum, just one cell. Go up to Insert, and then click on Table. Now notice the screen tip tells us the keyboard, Control-T. And because the Excel table feature is so handy, we're always going to use the keyboard, Control-T. The Create Table dialog box pops up. Because we have field names at the top and it has some formatting to distinguish it from the data below, it knows that we have what they call headers checked. Now when we click OK, it adds formatting for us. It also adds sorting and filtering dropdowns. And the most important thing is if we add a new column or new rows to the bottom of the table, all of that new data will be recognized by any report or charts or other things like formulas that are pointing to the table. Now, as soon as you Control-T to a table, you want to go up to Table Design, Properties, and name your table. Now we're going to call this F Sales. The F is because these are the type of facts that we're going to summarize. And the table is about sales, so we called it Sales.